Vladimir Putin is still launching his assault against Ukraine, and right now it doesn't appear that he has any real strategy about what the hell to do in the country. Now, there have been casualties in this war. There have been hundreds of Russian soldiers that have died. There's been countless Ukrainians that have been killed so far. It is a bloodbath. We're watching as Russia sends missiles to civilian areas in Ukraine. Peace talks have stalled, although the Ukrainian government, of course, says they may have plans to negotiate with Russia. You know, we may have an idea on how to make these things happen, but so far we have not seen any of it come to fruition. And based on what we know, Russia is refusing to back down on any of their demands, which of course includes Ukraine adding to their constitution that they will never join NATO. It forces Ukraine to recognize Russia's annexing of Crimea. And of course, they have to give up the sovereign parts of Ukraine to Russia. So basically, you can't do anything to protect yourself, and we're taking part of your country too. Those are Russia's demands. Those were the demands before the invasion even happened, and Russia does not appear to be backing down. So I don't know what Ukraine means when they say we may have an idea on how to move forward with negotiations, but I guess time will tell. But they're also at a point where they may not need to concede anything. Russia is not winning this invasion. They are being held back by a military force and a population that is far less equipped than they are. And that has put Russia and Vladimir Putin on their heels. They did not expect this. They went into Ukraine thinking that they would be able to conquer these areas before the West could even tie their shoes. But that didn't happen. And because of that, because of Ukraine fighting them back, the West was able to mobilize, take action, initiate the sanctions, basically send their economy tumbling. The rupee, you know, is worth absolutely nothing right now. And it's hurting everybody in Russia. It's hurting the needy citizens of Russia who don't want any part of this, who don't want to be part of this invasion, and who are being arrested for protesting the invasion. Those are the ones who are suffering the most, and that, of course, is absolutely unfair. So Vladimir Putin has now put himself between a rock and a hard place. There's no easy way for him to get out at this point. You know, he can't just say, all right, screw it, troops come back, we're done. No, because he has to save face with his people. If he were to retreat right now, well, that's a sign of weakness. And God knows Vladimir Putin's not going to let anybody view him as a weak individual. And that's where things get more dangerous. A weakened Putin, a scared Putin, is a more dangerous Putin. And I'm afraid that is what we're dealing with now, right? That is the phase we have entered with this conflict. So the question now is, what does a scared Putin do? Scared of losing his own power in Russia? Scared of losing this conflict? Scared of the sanctions that have been placed on his country that are crippling it? How does he respond to this? We do not have answers to that. Nobody, by the way, has answers to that. Anybody who claims to, don't listen to them, because nobody knows how this is all going to play out. But what I'm saying is that things are starting to look even scarier. Because with Putin's back up against the wall, there is no telling how he is going to lash out. The best thing, of course, would be if he walked away from this and the conflict ceased immediately. But he's not going to do that. We're going to see more death. We're going to see more fighting. We're going to see more suffering of the civilians in both Russia and Ukraine. Because that's what Putin wants. He will sacrifice whoever it is, Ukrainians, Russians, doesn't matter, to save face and not be viewed as weak. And if he thinks that that is right on the horizon, he's going to lash out even harder, and that could be devastating for that entire region. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.